Hi, thanks for joining us. My name is Jacob Chapman. I'm a senior solutions architect with Nozomi Networks, and I'm joined here by, joined here by Jim. Do you want to give a quick intro about yourself?
Yeah, hey guys. Jim Montgomery, I'm the director of solution architects for TXOne Networks.
Awesome, and we are here to tell you about how Nozomi Networks technology and TXOne technology come together to deliver value to customers for monitoring and protection for OT environments. A little bit of background in Nozomi Networks in 15 seconds. We are a cybersecurity monitoring software company. We provide a platform for detecting threats within OT and IoT networks and environments. Our platform is deployed in everything from critical infrastructure like electric distribution and maritime ships, all the way to IoT environments like retail shopping locations, malls, and public transit. I can basically guarantee you that at some point you've been on a train or taken a cruise or flown through an airport that's being monitored by Nozomi Networks technology. With that said, Nozomi has seen a lot of success as OT security has become more important over the years. We now have offices and deployments on all six continents, roughly 8,500 worldwide installations, monitoring roughly 90 million devices. Now, with that said, no matter how good Nozomi Networks technology is, we rely on service provider partners and technology partners to really deliver the value of our technology to our customers. And key among them is TXOne Networks, who helps to provide the protection side of the equation. So Nozomi Networks platform is all about monitoring and detection, but really for taking action on the detections and the alerts and protecting the environment, we work with TXOne to do that. So with that, I'll hand it off to Jim. Cool.
Thanks, Jacob. Yeah, so probably first question, who is TXOne? TXOne was really created specifically for protection in OT environments. So when you look at an OT environment, the specific requirements of an OT environment with legacy software or unique network requirements, we were created specifically for those types of scenarios. We've got some very good recognition over the last couple of years, which is on the slide. But again, when you look at TXOne Networks, we're really the protection arm of the visibility that Nozomi delivers. So multiple attack vectors and surfaces, I'll just build this slide. Generally what we see is we see the attacks bleeding in either from IT or from an external resource. So when you talk about air-gapped environments or isolated environments, we find that a lot of times that's not really an accurate depiction of what's going on in the environment. There's logging, there's telemetry, there's VPN access, there's any number of different vulnerability or access points into environments. And that's what we really aim to protect. We aim to block those specific areas of attack and deliver protection in OT environments. So security operations, this is challenging for a lot of people. Generally, you have an IT security operations center. IT is very involved in the networking capabilities, the protection strategies. OT is a little different. OT is really still coming up to speed with regard to security and the need for security. There's a lot of awareness being built through the visibility vendors specifically about what's out there and the vulnerabilities that exist. But as far as protection, that's a little bit off the chart still, but becoming much, much more prevalent and much, much more important in OT environments. So what are we trying to do? We're trying to create a framework for protection, right? Nothing really exists today. Standards are being developed. NIST is coming out with some standards. CIS is coming out with standards. There's a lot of information being generated, but we're really still building that platform on what that security structure looks like. But that's one of our goals in partnering with Nozomi is delivering a complete visibility and protection strategy to deliver to an OT environment. Multiple vectors, so supply chain attacks, are you getting tools into the environment that may be compromised already, being shipped with malware, endpoint attacks, network attacks, insider attacks. So these are all specifically designed and specifically created for OT environments now, more and more being targeted towards OT environments. So we're seeing a lot of interaction in OT environments with regard to specific vulnerabilities and specific attacks. Again, specifically ransomware, we see that bleeding over from IT, and that's typically where a lot of that comes from. Product lines, we have three different protection strategies. Our core protection strategy with Nozomi is our network gear. So the networking capabilities, the networking protection that we deliver can actually integrate with Nozomi's visibility and deliver a protection strategy into your environment. So what does that look like from a practical standpoint? Well, we're doing network segmentation, we're doing virtual patching, trustless, hardening critical assets against vulnerabilities. And again, looking at that supply chain, which is extremely important and becoming more important, protecting that supply chain of items or devices coming into the environment that either are already compromised or a specific source of compromise. So response, how are we getting that response? It's a very simple API integration with Nozomi. We're actually building off of that visibility and that data that's already out there in the Nozomi networks, and then bringing it in to actually block in the environment. It's kind of what it looks like when we see it. So we gather the information, we create policies and rules automatically based upon the telemetry that's delivered from Nozomi, and we create blocking lists. So it's very simple, very easy to implement, and very very well educated based upon the telemetry that we're actually gathering.
Awesome. That's it. Yeah, just one last thing I would highlight is how the technologies can work together to help to achieve scale. I think many OT organizations have many facilities, many environments that need both monitoring and detection. Both of our platforms are really built for that scalability, as well as allowing limited security teams to be able to do more, even with fewer resources and time on their hands. So I think that's just a key thing I'd highlight. But with that, let me see. Thank you guys for joining us. If you'd like more information, please do visit our websites, nozominetworks.com and txone.com.
Thanks.